Oh, she has cancer. But I know how this ends. Called it. Welcome to Travis Book Reviews, where I review books based on how enjoyable they are and nothing else. Today we have The Fault in Our Stars, the Book of YouTube, apparently. If you're not familiar with my reviews, basically it goes right down the score sheet and all I care about is how enjoyable the book is, how fun it is. I don't care about all the pretentious stuff. So I was initially very hesitant to review this book. Actually, I was hesitant to read it because of how big it is on YouTube. And no, it's not because I'm a hipster that doesn't like to read popular things. It's because the reason I thought that this book would be so huge and popular on YouTube was because John and Hank Green are massive on YouTube and have a cult following. You can call it what you want, but it's a cult following. And sometimes that cult following is very alarming. So I figured they blew the book out of proportion and it really wasn't as good as I said it was. And almost everybody I've heard talk about this book on YouTube, they act like it is the greatest thing that's ever happened. But I eventually caved in. I decided to read it, and then once I read it, I decided I might as well review it. Nerdfighteria pretends to be open-minded and against bullying, so we'll see in the comments in a little while how many hypocrites there are in that community. So, let's get started on the review. First category is premise, and the premise of this book is about a girl that has cancer. Her name is Hazel, and she falls in love with a boy who had cancer, and that's pretty much everything. I don't know if it would be a spoiler, but I'm gonna go ahead and say a little bit more. The boy who was supposedly recovered from his cancer got more cancer and ended up dying. Now that's a central plot point, but it's not something that's going to be hidden through the book. Probably everybody knows that, so I'm not really too concerned about that being a spoiler, but you can hate me if you want to consider that a spoiler. So premise, what I usually judge on is originality and how much interest it sparks in me before I read it, or while I read it. And let's be honest here, there is an entire subgenre of books that I like to call cancer books. They're all over the place. If you read a Nicholas Sparks book, it's probably about cancer. Having characters fall in love and one of them has cancer and dies is nowhere near original now. It's seriously, seriously overplayed. So I cannot mark it high for that. Originality, completely, completely unoriginal. I can name 6 or 7 books right off the top of my head that are exactly like it as far as premise goes. The premise, however, is it unappealing? Is it something that I wouldn't want to read? Not necessarily, because books like that, they can sometimes be very, very gripping books, and that's what I heard this one would be, and that falls down to characters and writing, which obviously will come later. But for premise, I can't mark it up any just because it did end up being very well fleshed out. So I'm gonna give it 3 stars. It's unoriginal. I mean, that's all there is to it. Now writing. What I judge writing by is how clear the prose is, how well it transports you into the story, how visual it makes the scene so you can see what's going on. And in a first person like this is written in, how well you can feel the character. I don't care about fancy syntax and huge vocabulary and everything like that. All I care about is how well it acts as the median to the story. And like when I first started reading this, I was like, wow, that's like really good. Because like there was some really funny stuff in here because it's like first person from Hazel and like she's a crazy teenager. The farther, like, I got into it, I noticed, like, there was this one thing that, like, kept bothering me. And I, like, initially I wanted to, like, make it, like, a 5-star writing because it was really sarcastic and witty and fun. And that's, like, what I like. That's the stuff that I really like. But, like, there was just this one thing that, like, kept popping up. And it kept, like, annoying me because though Hazel is, like, an extremely intelligent girl in the book, and she like uses words that most teenagers like shouldn't use. She kept like saying this one word like all the time, and it was like, and she like kept saying like, and cropped up over and like over and like over. And at first I thought she was being like sarcastic, be like, oh, I'm a normal teenage like girl. But like it started showing up in places where she shouldn't have been like sarcastic or anything like that. And the more it like showed up, the more it like bothered me. So like, I'm gonna knock a star off for that because it's just like, it bothered me. But that's a personal thing. So like, it might not be a bad thing for you, but like most of the writing is like really, really good. So like 4 stars. Should have been 5, but I have a pet peeve. Humor. Humor is simply the asides and the funny jokes and everything. If it goes well, the entire book doesn't have to be funny, and this is a tragedy, so of course it's not funny. Right off the bat, 5 stars. I'm gonna tell you straight away, this book is hilarious. It has some awesome one-liners in it. There's a line early in the book where she was talking about how she first got diagnosed with cancer, and it said something along the lines of, it was like nature telling me, congratulations, you're a woman, now die. And that was really sarcastic and horrible, and I laughed my ass off for like 5 minutes. I just said like, oh God. Hazel and Augustus are both witty and sarcastic, which I like sarcasm. It's what I live for. So 5 stars on the humor. All the asides hit. It was great. Character. So the two main characters are Hazel and Augustus. They're both very nerdy teenagers with cancer. That's the best way to describe them. They come off as a bit pretentious at times because they use vocabulary that there is quite frankly no sense for. But not overly badly. Overall, I did like them. They were deep and pretty well fleshed out. So when Augustus ended up biting it, which I feel like I'm spoiling it, but everybody should, it's what the book's about. It's the journey, not the ending. But when Augustus ended up biting it, it was a little sad, I'm not gonna lie. It probably would have upset me a lot more if I haven't read 1,000 books just like this, and I'm gonna be honest with you on that one. After so many cancer books, you get a little numb to it. But characters, 5 stars, very, very deep, very well fleshed out. Journey. Journey is simply how much I enjoyed reading the book. In other words, how fun it was. How much I enjoyed it. If it got to be a grind, that's bad. If I wanted nothing more than to read it and turned every page and couldn't put it down, then that's a great journey. This book is short, and short often, but not always, means easy read. And it was an easy read in this case. It was predictable. I'm not going to lie, the plot line was predictable. One of the big plot points in the book is when they go to visit Hazel's favorite author who wrote a book that she loves. His name was Peter Van Houten, the author. And I figured when they went to visit him, I said to myself, self, he's going to be an asshole. And guess what? Self wasn't wrong. Peter Van Houten was very much just like Forrester from Finding Forrester. He was a bitter old man that stopped writing for bitter old reasons. And he was an alcoholic too. Basically, he was your stereotypical, crazy, reclusive, one-time, one-hit wonder, genius author from any book or movie or whatever. So that was predictable. Everything was predictable. When Augustus was like, I had cancer, but I'm cured, I went, that boy's gonna die. And he died. Very predictable. But the pacing was good. The writing was good. And it was short. It was a good read. I enjoyed most of the time I spent reading it. So I will give it 5 stars for Journey. So ending. This is normally where the spoilers come in, but I think I've given them all. The end of it. Augustus dies. Okay? Hazel's left alive. And she had cared for him. It was a lot like the last song. If you've read the last song, just it was her boyfriend instead of her father this time. Very sad, all the touchy stuff leading up to the death. They had a fake funeral and all that jazz. And after he dies, one of Hazel and Augustus's mutual friends, Isaac, reveals that Augustus had been writing something. So Hazel goes on a crusade to find what he had been writing. Eventually she found it, and it was a letter to Peter Van Houten urging him to write a eulogy for Hazel. And Hazel read it, and then she got to the end, and then the book was over. It just kind of ended all of a sudden. Not a big fan of sudden endings, which I, once again, kind of thought would be happening, because the fictional book that she loved so much in this book, it ended randomly in the middle of a sentence. This one didn't end quite that suddenly. But basically, Augustus said, in the end of his thing that I like my choices, I hope she likes hers. And she says, I do, Augustus, I do. Which is cheesy and melodramatic and over the top, let's be honest with it. I'm having trouble thinking of what to say about the ending other than the fact that it just ended. A boy got cancer and he died. And his girlfriend was sad, but then very glad that she had had the chance to know him. Just like every other cancer book you've read. So ending, I'm going to give it 3 stars. Overall, this is a good book. It is a good book. Is it overrated? You betcha. I've heard a lot of people say that it's not about cancer. It's about living. And they just happen to have cancer. If it had been a book about 2 teenagers that fell in love and neither one of them had cancer, it wouldn't have been about anything. The book revolves around cancer. But let me repeat again. It is a good book. Okay? It's a good, solid book. The reason I believe it's overrated lies in the fact that I do not believe it is unique. If you read a Nicholas Sparks book or any other countless books about cancer and love, it's going to be extremely similar to this book. This book is a good book, but it's not special. There's a million like it. That said, I'm going to give it 4 stars. It's a very good book. If you haven't read it, by all means, you should give it a read. If you don't read a lot, you might be blown away by this book. You really might be. And I can see why people are. If they don't read as widely as I do and a lot of other people do, you'll be astounded by this book. Not unique, but good. And in the comment section below, you can either prove your maturity or just blindly hate me for giving my honest opinion. But this has been a Travis Book Review, where I'm always honest. And until next time, keep reading.
The safety in the numbers of this godforsaken town. It's been a week since all of this went down. In this abandoned factory, there's no one here but you and